Welcome to the Abyss. I'm Jacqueline, and this is the second part in our seaweed series. In this video, we're discussing the many ways you're eating and consuming seaweed, some of which you probably didn't even realize. Let's dive in. Many people think of seaweed as the gross, slimy stuff that touches your feet when you're swimming. While this is true, seaweed is also incredibly important, not just in the ecological sense, but also commercially. It is estimated that the seaweed industry is worth over $6 billion, and is an industry that is continually growing. Of the seaweeds that are grown and harvested commercially, it is mainly different species of red and brown algae. The production of seaweed can range from small harvesting of wild seaweeds to large industrial aquaculture operations. Mainly, seaweed is produced through aquaculture. Seaweed is mainly produced for use in the food industry. Seaweed has been part of the human diet for thousands of years all over the world. It is a traditional food in many Eastern Asian countries such as Japan, China, and Korea. Around 80% of seaweed production is for direct human consumption. It is eaten for both its nutritional value as well as used as flavor. One nutritional benefit of seaweed is that it is high in vitamins, especially vitamins A, B, and E. Another nutritional benefit is that it is high in minerals, which can account for about a third of its total dry weight. They accumulate these minerals from the surrounding seawater. In particular, seaweed is a great source of iodine compared to plants. Nori is by far the largest seaweed product and the one most people are familiar with. It is mainly eaten as dry roasted sheets as well as used in the making of sushi. Although you'd never know it by looking at nori, but it is actually a red seaweed. It is the thallus of species in the genus Porphyra. The process of drying out and roasting the nori results in it losing its red color and giving it the dark green, black color we are all familiar with. It is made by shredding and drying out pieces of seaweed and then forming them into sheets. This process is actually really similar to how paper is made. Nutritionally, similar to all seaweeds, nori has high levels of vitamins and minerals. In particular, nori has a high level of protein, which makes up about a third of its dry weight. It also has a really high level of vitamin C, with about 1.5 times the amount of vitamin C of an orange. Another commonly eaten seaweed is wakame, which is a brown algae. It is the species Ondaria pinnatifida. It is most commonly eaten and produced in Korea, Japan, and China. In its most popular form, it is boiled and salted. This causes it to be green in appearance instead of brown. It is then used in seaweed salads, soups, and noodle dishes. Much smaller in production and consumption, the nori and wakame is dulse. It is another species of seaweed that is commonly eaten whole as food. Dulse is the species Palmaria palmata, which is a red seaweed. It is found in the northern Atlantic and is therefore more commonly eaten in western countries such as Iceland and here in eastern Canada. The whole thallus is dried out and is eaten as a snack. Besides eating the seaweeds themselves, chemicals extracted from the seaweeds are also widely used in the food industry, as well as the industrial, cosmetic, and medical industries. Heat is used to extract the chemicals, called phycocolloids, from the seaweeds. The seaweeds go through extensive processing to extract the final product. This processing depends on the particular product, but can include filtration and purification steps. Carrageenan and agar are the phycocolloids extracted from red algae, while alginates are extracted from brown. Carrageenan, agar, and alginate all have similar uses as food additives. One of their most common uses is as a gelling agent, where they help to thicken food and give it a smooth consistency. Because of these properties, they are found in a wide range of foods such as puddings, pastry, and pie fillings, and even this ready-made cheesecake. Another use for agar, carrageenan, and alginates is as an emulsifier. Emulsifiers are important in helping to stabilize food and keep them from separating. This is useful in many products, such as chocolate milk and coffee creamer. Emulsifiers are also incredibly important in ice cream. Without them, the water and fat would separate and result in ice crystals. Agar, in particular, is able to form a stable gel in a variety of conditions, such as varying temperatures and humidities. This makes it ideal for a variety of applications, and why it is commonly used as a media in petri dishes. Consequently, agar is the most expensive of the phycocolloids. With that, I hope you have a newfound appreciation for seaweed, because without it, you could end up with ice crystals in your ice cream. Let me know your favorite fruit containing seaweed down below. Mine is definitely ice cream, but I'm pretty excited to eat all these foods. Make sure to subscribe to stay current on our videos, and until next time, I will see you later.